Naftali Bennett was sworn in as Israel's 13th Prime Minister on Sunday. With this, the decade-long reign of Benjamin Netanyahu has come to an end. Who is Naftali Bennett? What are his politics? Here's all you need to know. Born in 1972 to American parents, Bennett is a modern Orthodox Jew, entrepreneur and a serial investor. He has served in the Israeli army and holds a Bachelor of Law degree from the Hebrew University in Jerusalem. Bennett is considered close to Benjamin Netanyahu and has held various positions in his cabinet. He also ran Netanyahu's campaign ahead of the primary elections for the leadership of the Likud party. Even though Bennett shares many of Netanyahu's ideals, he is considered to be more right-wing than Netanyahu. Bennett swearing in will put an end to Israel's ongoing search for a new government. The nation's parliament has been dissolved multiple times over the last couple of years as Netanyahu couldn't broker a deal and remain in power. The country went to polls 4 times in 2 years. Bennett has become the PM even though his party, the ultra-nationalist Yamina party, won just 7 seats in the elections held in March. The Israeli parliament is a 120-member house. He leads a fragile coalition with a narrow majority and includes parties from the left, right and the center. In fact, Bennett only became PM after he agreed to serve as the Prime Minister for 2 years before handing over power to the Lapid party, which is the architect of the coalition. He is opposed to the Palestinian independence and strongly supports the Jewish settlements in occupied West Bank and East Jerusalem. He is a supporter of the Greater Land of Israel. The 49-year-old shares many of Netanyahu's ideals, including the hawkish approach to the conflicts in West Asia. However, he criticized Netanyahu when the then Prime Minister agreed to slow down settlement construction under pressure from the former US President Barack Obama. Although Israeli politics is moving to a newer generation of leaders with Bennett taking over, his hardline views could hamper the return of peace in the volatile nation.